And the reason why I'm making this video is I don't want anyone to be victimized by such a simple problem. Having a $15 capacitor and the ability to swap it out could literally save you several thousands of dollars. I kid you not. Around 6 years ago, our compressing unit did not work. And so we didn't have any contacts in the local area, and we asked for a referral. The person that came over basically told us that we needed to replace the exterior unit. What ended up happening was that we called around, and it was very expensive. But fortunately, I had a friend who was in the business. What ended up happening is when he arrived with all the new equipment, he was looking at the old unit, and I asked him if it was salvageable. And one of the first things he ended up doing was putting a capacitor into the exterior unit, and it fired up. So we were very upset that we were scammed by someone who wanted to replace our compressor unit when all it needed was a capacitor. And because my friend had already committed to the brand new air conditioning system and the fact that it was the original unit, and I think it was between 15 to 20 years old, it was probably time to replace it anyhow. The hard lesson we learned was that the exterior unit that we had was in fact just fine. All it needed was a $15 capacitor. And the reason why I'm making this video is I don't want anyone to be victimized by such a simple problem. Having a $15 capacitor and the ability to swap it out could literally save you several thousands of dollars. I kid you not. As I said, I was quite fortunate to have a friend that was in the business, and he explained how it all worked, but I have never forgotten the lesson. So I'm outside next to our house, and what I'm going to do is demonstrate how to swap out a capacitor from our Goodman unit. It is October, but it's still pretty warm today, so I'm sweating a little bit here. But you will see how easy it is to swap out a capacitor.
First, we are going to set our thermostat to the off position. This is our Goodman compressor unit and the exterior setup. I cleared the bushes so I would have better access to the compressor unit. Before you continue forward, I have a quick disclaimer. I am not an HVAC technician, nor am I qualified to give expert advice on HVAC systems. What I'm sharing here is strictly for educational purposes. I replace my own capacitor because I am comfortable doing so. If you are not comfortable doing this, you should definitely call a local professional HVAC expert for your system. I'm going to cut the power to the compressor unit so that I don't electrocute myself. Next, I get a hex nut screwdriver to undo the screws. I have a pair of pliers on standby in case I can't disconnect the capacitor with my fingers. I locate the two screws I have to unscrew to remove the cover plate. I unscrew the two screws to remove the cover plate. The cover plate comes off easily once the two screws are removed. I loosen the screw to the capacitor holder so that I can lift the capacitor out. At this point, I could have tried to lift the capacitor out before undoing the connections, but I wasn't sure I had enough cable length. So I decided to remove the connections with my fingers. If the connections were too tight, I had my pliers on standby to use. I'm sorry that my head blocked the view as I undid the connections. I did my best to stay out of the camera's way, but it was a cramped area. After the connections are removed and the holder is loosened, the capacitor pops right out. Next, I am going to get a new capacitor. When I connect the new capacitor, I have to remember that the brown wire goes to the fan and the yellow wire goes to the HERM. I connect the wires in that order. The remaining red and purple wires go to the remaining connector. I start with the brown wire, which I will connect to the fan terminal. I then connect the yellow wire to the HERM terminal. And finally, I connect the purple and red wires to the C terminal. I then slide the capacitor back to its holder and tighten the screw with the hex nut screwdriver. I put the cover plate back on and put back the screws I removed earlier. I reactivate the power. I go inside and turn the thermostat to cool. If everything is done correctly, the compressor will come back on and start cooling the house again.
Thank you for watching this video. If you liked the video, do me a favor and hit the like button. While you're at it, go ahead and hit the subscribe button so that you can receive notifications of future videos. And I will see you in my next video.